Hello students, I welcome you all to our online teaching. Hope you all are fit, fine, healthy and happy at your homes. Our school has started online teaching. So be safe at home itself and study well. And I thank God for giving this opportunity to teach online. And I would like to extend my warmest wishes to you all on the beginning of the new academic year. Now let us start from the chapter 1, Hardware Components of Computer. In this chapter, we are going to see about computer, computer characteristics, IPO cycle, computer system, hardware and software. First we see about computer. Anyone knows what is a computer? Yes, computer is an electronic device. In this, a computer can be defined as an electronic device that can accept, store and process data to produce the required result according to user directions. The next is the computer characteristics. What is the first characteristics? The first computer characteristics is speed. Computer works at great speeds. It can do a billions of actions in a few seconds itself. And then the next characteristic is memory. Computer stores a large amount of data safely in its memory for future use. The next is accuracy. Computer cannot do any mistakes. It is a very accurate machine. The next characteristics is diligence. Computers can do the job again and again without getting tired or bored. The next characteristics is versatility. Computers can perform different types of jobs. The next characteristics is capacity. It stores a large volumes of data. Next, our topic is IPO cycle. A computer cannot work on its own. We need to enter letter, numbers, pictures, and instruction into the computer to make it work. A computer works in three basic steps, which is called IPO cycle. A computer works in this three basic steps. Let us see how computer works in this three basic steps. We have to give the input. The computer will process and display the results as output. Now we can give the input as data and instructions that we enter into a computer by an input device, keyboard and mouse. This is the input. 7 and 3 is the data and the plus is the instruction we give to the computer as addition. The next is process. CPU works on the data 7 plus 3. Then it gives the output 10. Output is the final result. It will display in the monitor. Mom, I haven't out. Yes, tell me. I did not understand about IPO cycle. Okay, let us see some real life examples. Okay, ma'am. The first real life example of IPO cycle is sharpening the pencil. This is a new pencil. then it's sharpening. It gives the sharpened pencil. In this, the input is the new pencil. The process is sharpening the pencil, and the output is sharpened pencil. Next, we move on to the next examples of IPO cycle. In this, the example is brushing the teeth. Now, you all are tell me in this, which is the input? Yes, very good. The brush and the paste is input. Process? Yes, correct. Brushing the teeth is the process. It gives output clean teeth. Yes, very good. Next example is our body. If a teacher asks us a question, we can hear it by our ears and see it by our eyes. This is, we are getting the input through our ears and eyes. Process. The process is by our brain. Our brain stores everything that a teacher says, then think of an answer and order us to speak. The brain works as a processing unit. Then the output is when we answer it our by mouth. It works like output unit. Okay. Now you all can understand about IPO cycle? Yes, ma'am. Yes. Okay. Next, we move on to the next topic, computer system. A computer has a monitor, a mouse, a keyboard, and a case that contains other important parts. A computer system has two components, that is hardware and software. First, we see about hardware. Hardware are the physical parts that can be seen and touched. All input, output, and processing devices are hardware. Let us see some examples. For input device, the example is keyboard and mouse. These are used to enter input to the computer. The next is processing device. Example is CPU. These are used to process the input which we received from the user. The next is a storage device. Example is pen drive, CD, and DVD, etc. Storage devices are used to store input and output for the later use. The next is the output device. The example for output device is monitor and printer. These display the result of computer processing. Okay, you all understand about the hardware? Okay, next we move on to software. Software are the programs that instructs a computer to do different tasks. Software is a set of instructions that tells hardware what to do. It is shown on the desktop in the form of an icon, which you can neither touch nor feel a software. In this, there are two types of software. One is application software and the another one is system software. Application software programs are designed for specific purposes. Some commonly used application softwares are Paint, MS Word, Windows Media Player, etc. Then is the system software. System software runs the application software. Then the system software control and manages your computer. Next, hardware and software. Both the hardware and software are interdependent. Without a software, a computer cannot run. And without hardware, no software can run. Let us see example. A computer plays a song which are stored in a CD or DVD and speaker or all hardware devices. While the songs are played is a software. Okay, hope you all understand. With that, we are done the topics. Let's do a simple recapitulation. The first question is the computer. Define a computer. Hope you all know the answer. Yes, a computer can be defined as an electronic device that can accept, store, and process data to produce the required result according to user directions. The next question is expand IPO. Anyone? Yes, input, process, output. Very good. The next question is list the characteristics of computer. Speed, memory, accuracy, diligence, versatility, capacity. Yes, good. The next question is state hardware and software. Hardware are the physical parts that can be seen and touched. Software are the program that instructs the computer to do different tasks. Yes, very good. I have given you the activity in the Google Classroom. You all can enjoy the activity. So do the activity. To do the activity, you can join the Google Classroom. To join Google Classroom, type classroom.google.com in a browser or download a Google Classroom from the Play Store. This is the Google Classroom icon. After downloaded the Google Classroom, in the Google Classroom right corner, there is an plus symbol. Click the plus symbol. There will be a two options, join class or create class. Choose join class. If you join class, the join class dialog box will be open. Then enter the code, Google Classroom code in this place. N2NGI66. All the letters will be in the small letters. Then click join. If you click join, the classroom will be opened. This is our new classroom. In this, I have posted a activity. For the first activity, play the activity and take a screenshot of your marks and then click add or create. If you click in this, the list of the options will be displayed. In this, choose file. If you choose a file, then it will move to your gallery, then select the screenshot of your score, then upload it in the classroom. After uploading it, click the option hand in or turn in or mark it as done. Then you will be awarded marks based on that. Complete the activity within 2 days itself. Then only you will get a full mark. Hope you all enjoyed the class very well. If you have any doubt, ask in the Google Classroom. Thank you, students.